Hi guys, this is Jordan with Motion Array. Today we're going to be going over a custom transition that you can make inside of After Effects. It's called a zoom blur, and this is what it looks like. The idea is that your clips transition as if your camera is zooming from one location to a new position. The great part about this effect is that it can work for any two clips, but it has a particularly special impact if you use it between two clips that look like different coverage of the same location. So let's get started. The first thing we're going to do is bring our clips into a new composition. We're going to take the clip that we want to see first and place it above the clip we want to transition into. Find the parts of the clip that you want to have included in the shot, and also the point at which you want the switch to happen from one clip to another. If you're having trouble seeing your bottom clip and making adjustments to it, hit this eye symbol to disable your top layer, and making changes to your bottom layer will be a lot easier. Position your two clips so that they'll overlap for at least a few frames, positioned at the place you'd like them to switch. Great! Now trim your clips down to what you'd like to have included. And then to keep everything looking nice and tidy, we're going to set our in and out points with B and N, and then we're going to trim our composition to our work area. Awesome! At this point, this is what you should have. Nothing special. But we're about to see some bigger changes. The next step is to make an adjustment layer. Go to Layers, New, Adjustment Layer. Make sure that it's on top of both of your clips. Now go to the Effects tab and search for Transform. Drag it onto the adjustment layer, and right now, nothing should change. What we're going to do next is use our adjustment layer to zoom in. This way the motion will be exactly the same between the two clips underneath it, helping it to sell the effect more. Go to Transform underneath Effects, not the regular Transform section for your clip. Now keyframe the scale over the course of a few frames, maybe 3 to 5, to zoom in a significant amount. Finally, over the course of about 3 to 4 frames, keyframe your opacity for your top clip to drop to 0. Now we notice that our second clip follows through on the same motion, but it's way too big. So we're going to go to the second clip's transform options and change its size so that at the end of the transition, it appears as the intended size. Now our transition looks like this, a lot better. But we still see that there's black surrounding the clip because we shrunk it at the start of the zoom. But we can hide this by adding what's called a motion tile. Go to your effects panel and choose the motion tile. Drag it onto your clip and bring your playhead to the first point at which you can see your clip. Within the motion tile effect, increase your output height and width, and you'll see that the video clip repeats itself in a tile pattern. Extend it until it covers the whole frame. But what can look a lot better is if you mirror the edges of your clip. So click this button here, and there you go, it looks like one continuous visual piece of footage. So now, let's take a look at our effect. We're getting closer, but now is where we're going to get into a few settings and details that are essential for this effect to work properly. Highlight your adjustment layer, and under the Transform effect, uncheck Use Composition Shutter Angle. And here underneath for Shutter Angle, we're going to input our own. Type in 180. Doing this will tell the transform effect to make realistic motion blur for any of the keyframes that we make inside of it. So if we look at our zoom, it now looks like the camera is zooming in with things being blurred around it. It gives a very realistic flair to our motion. And if you like, this is the way that you can potentially leave it. But if you want to finesse the effect a little bit more, here's one thing that you can do. In your adjustment layer, go to your zoom keyframes from your transform effect. Highlight them, and then go to your graph editor. Now let's add an easy ease for both of these and change the curve of the motion so that it looks a little bit more dramatic. Nice! And there you've just created a custom zoom blur effect that can really add a lot of impact to your video. I hope you guys found this video helpful. Thank you so much for watching, and I hope to see you in the next video.